So in the pictures, these guys had an extra bit welded on here. And it was kind of mysterious to me. It was like, oh, I must have done some miscalculation. And then when I was working on this right here, just seeing where this guy should go, the reason for the mysterious bit became obvious. I should have been able to figure it out. It's just there's not quite enough space to fit the blade in, so there needs to be like just an extra thing welded on so this guy can go on. And instead of welding on an extra weirdo strip, I've decided to nip this guy here and make a different plate. That way I think it'll just be neater and tidier than what I did before. There's a little part here where the edge is melted. I want to fill it in so I can, you know, grind, sand it back so it's flat.
Okay.
I got Evan to do this plate with a big gouge out of here so I can weld without it sticking to the table. Drill the first hole, put it together, and see that that actually works. That I haven't gone insane. So that position will work. If you slap this guy on here, you can get it to balance such that this flat bit at the end is level with the edge of the 40 mil, which was the plan. Now I'm going to weld a bit in here that makes contact with this part of the blade, the flat part on the back, and stops it proceeding further. Hopefully stops it clanging off this guy. Clang! So that's that nugget wedged in there, touching off the back, the edge of the blade. I can't remember what I did on the other blade I made. Did I have, like, any kind of a lock system to stop it, like, ramming into the edge? Can't remember. Now that that's in there, I'm gonna drill these holes. There seems to be a lot of like back and forth and back and forth and back and forth with making the parts of this thing. This thing has to be lined up so this thing can be lined up so this thing can be lined up, and it just never ends. I was afraid it would be too close to the one of the edges, but that's about right. So I had to loosen these using the spanners. It's amazing. There's so little of the actual hex shape left, but it still grabs a spanner. Wait, not a spanner. Wrench? What do Americans call them? You get the idea. But these are little custom things for holding in the blade either side. Gotta cut the piece that goes either side now. Clunk! Thing. The nugget I need needs to be 23.12. It's not behaving like mild steel. It was very squeaky and screechy when I was trying to tap it. To complicate things. I also welded the edges of the hole together and then die ground it back out to shape so it wasn't a perfectly round hole. So it was very complainy when I was trying to tap that. Now, I got poor Eben to bend this ring out cold. He had to do it with his manful arms. Unfortunately, I didn't have footage for it because I was out at the time. But, so I'm going to weld this guy on here, and that will be the finger pull. When I did it last time, this thing was made out of a washer, which didn't quite, it just wasn't that comfortable on the finger. So this time we have custom quarter inch ring. Now, to bend this guy to be parallel with the ring. Do I have a way of seeing, is it the same length either side? It looks about right. But I'm not 100% sure. You know, I keep messing around with the mechanism, trying to get it just right. The top of it had these four, or rather, there was these four studs poked into it to stop it rotating in the thing, and it worked. It might have worked much better when this thing was wider, but I didn't like it, so I added this little square plate underneath, and hopefully that will keep it from going this way when it's in the mechanism. I sometimes get asked, "Hey, Mike, how often do you make mistakes?" And it's like, you know, relatively often, but I usually catch them before I'm drilling holes and stuff. But not this time. The way the device opens, this was going to be my point for securing the spring for this guy. Clink, clink, clink. But it interferes with the rotation of the device. See, it's way too close. So I'm going to have to move this back quite a bit. And this hole on the device, this isn't really a mistake, but this hole does nothing now. So I'm going to fill in both of these holes on both plates. And that's the two holes gone. This donut representing the furthest edge on this guy was just for drawing a line and telling me what's the distance I cannot go past when I'm drilling the hole I want to drill for holding the spring in place for the lock mechanism. It might go smaller as well. I had it as quarter inch before, but I don't actually think it needs to be that hefty. in the closed position, there's a little bit of give that I don't like. So I'm trying to tighten up the lock position by, not the lock position, the opposite, the rest position, by putting in a nut, welding in a nugget here. And but the annoying thing is I have to tack it in position to make sure it's in the correct position. Otherwise, I'll just be guessing. So this is a really finicky weld, and I hope I don't mess it up. My camera ran out of batteries, but hopefully it caught the last bit. That's the nugget fused in there. It'll be more clear and obvious what's going on when I take the thing apart. Focus. That's the nuggety thing welded in. Just to make the lock, the closed position a bit tighter. Actually, I was looking at this thing and I was going to add a nugget like this in over here, but this guy pulls back further for locking into here. And I think it's because on the, well, it's not a thing. I know on the original device, it's because it's trying to clear this ratchet wheel. Because this is the, it can't fold it on lock if it's still in. Anyway, doesn't matter. I can just make the notch deeper and it has the same effect. Okay, so that's the adjustments made to the locking mechanism. Can't get far enough back. And this is, I don't have the handle or anything, or the sides welded to it. That's the idea. With the trigger, there was too much play in this slot. I think there's still a little bit, but this nugget I've added here reduces the play down to something more manageable. The amount of play made it rattly in the open position and the closed position, so hopefully that will make everything a little bit smoother. I gotta add the other one now. Hopefully I can do just as neat of a job on the second one to weld it on the back. The original lock blade was supposed to have a handle on the back. It had like this weird stubby thing coming off here. And I always envisioned like a handle that you put your hand into, and then when you flick it open, your fingers don't have to be in this near the same plane as the opening blade. But I didn't have the time to do it. So on this one, we're putting the extra handle. Nice. I wish I'd drawn this guy closer to the edge. Would have been easier to clamp. This has to come off. Dang it! I should have pushed this forward. I have to clean up these more, but I'm going to wait till it's welded on before I do the final bevel, putting a little bevel on the insides and such like. I'm trying to match the angle here and the gap in here, so there's a similar gap all the way around when the sword is in its sheath. Before I tack these sides on, I want to bevel the edge that is facing forward because it will just be easier to do now while it's all separate. So that's the idea. See the rounded edge versus the square edge. Gotta do this one now. Might seem weird to tack it together like this when they're all assembled, but I just wanna double check that the parts actually fit together. I'll take it apart for doing the full welds, but I just wanna tack it like this. I was making this one absolutely a nightmare to do, but I got it. Now we're going to be welding, doing this big arm weld on the back and all around the edges of that guy. And I have another piece of half inch in there clamped. And my guess is this guy is going to need some sledgehammer love after I'm done to remain straight, but maybe not. You know, it might be too awkward for it to pull in the directions it wants to pull, but I guess we'll see once this is done. Abrupt cut to me standing here. The mighty algorithm says you guys only like 20-minute videos, so this video is broken up into parts, and there should be a box floating around the screen indicating a playlist with all of the parts that have currently been uploaded. If not all of the parts are up, then they'll be uploaded once a week till they are up. Alternatively, you can go over to my Patreon, where the full length of the video is uploaded right now as you're watching this. If the there's no box, because YouTube has changed its thing yet again, it's in the video description. There's me pointing down like an amateur in the year 2034, where you're watching this video from. The video description could be like anywhere, or just may not exist anymore, in which case, good luck.